All right, folks, so today we're going to be doing a bit of a project, and this is going to be an installation of the GC Loader PNP. This is a brand new optical drive emulator from Dan Kuntz over at Black Dog Technologies. This one was on pre-order, I think, since February, and it just came in, so I'm really excited to get into this. So essentially what this is an ODE, which will allow you to use your SD card to store all of your games and play your games on your GameCube. So looking at the GC Loader itself, obviously you can see there's an SD card slot on the top, along with a couple of chips. Unfortunately, I'm not that technologically minded, so I'm not going to try and explain what they all are. There's also a reset button on the top there too. Flipping it over, you can see the GC Loader icon along with the optical drive connector. Now this is a big upgrade from the original GC Loader that Dan put out. The original one didn't have the adapter pre-installed, so you actually had to remove it from your original GameCube laser unit and then solder it on yourself. So this should make the installation an absolute breeze. So now we've taken a look at the GC Loader itself, let's get into the installation. I'm really excited to get into this one, so let's go. Okay, so first let's take a look and see what we'll need to do this installation. First, obviously we need the GC Loader, so we have that. Next, obviously, again, we'll need a GameCube. Now, this is a Japanese Spice Orange GameCube. The GC Loader is region-free and will work with any region. So basically, whatever GameCube you have, this will work with. So next, we have something that's not required, but I thought this looked really cool, so I figured I'd order one of these as well. This is the GC Loader SD mount from Laser Bear Industries. This is available in all kinds of different colors, but I went with the orange one to match my system. And we'll take a closer look at this a little bit later on when we actually get to install it. Next, we have a Nintendo Security Bit driver. These are pretty easy to come by. You can get them on eBay or Amazon. I'll leave a link below for those. And I think also Dan was offering these as an add-on to the orders for the GC Loader. But this you'll need to get into the GameCube itself. Obviously, Nintendo has its own security bits, but you can use this to get into the GameCube itself. And finally, is just a standard number two Phillips screwdriver. So I'm assuming everybody should have one of those. All right, so I think that's everything that we're going to need, and we can get started. So the first thing we need to do, obviously, is get into the GameCube itself. So to protect the jewel on the top, because I don't want to get this scratched, I'm just going to cover this with a soft cloth, and then we're going to flip the GameCube over. And then just because I don't want them flying around as I'm moving the console around, I'm going to remove the expansion port covers. Nice and easy. Next, we'll use our Nintendo Security Bit driver to remove the four screws in the corners. And then once the four screws are out, we'll flip the GameCube back over onto its base. And obviously you'll see all the screws fall out, which is good. So we'll put those in a safe place. Get rid of this cloth here. And then you can remove the top of the GameCube just by lifting up easily. Nice and simple. Okay, so I think Nintendo got a really good deal on screws right around the time that they were building the GameCube, because this has an absolute ton of them. If you look down the side here, you can see all of those screws. There's some across the sides, the back, and actually a couple hidden under the fan there as well. So let's start off by taking off the controller ports. This is a really easy job. All we need to do is pull easily on the little clips here, and the controller port assembly just pops off at the front. And then we'll do the same again on the AV covers there. Again, that just pushes off really easily. It's just held on by a couple of clips. Okay, so now we need to grab our number two Phillips screwdriver. So we'll start off here on the fan assembly side, and I'm going to speed this up a little bit because this takes forever to get all the screws out. So we'll get moving through these as quickly as we can. Okay, so now moving through this pretty swiftly, we can remove the fan and power button assembly. And these are where you'll find the hidden screws. This is great because if you've never done this before, you think you're almost done. And there's a whole bunch more. So we'll get those ones out there too. Then I actually forgot there were four more screws in the front there behind the memory card assembly. So you'll see me there struggling to get the optical drive out, but it's actually not ready to go yet. So don't forget to take out the ones that are right behind the memory card port there. So we'll take those out real quick, and then the optical drive should be free and ready to go. All right, so with those screws out, we're now ready to take out the optical drive. And again, very similar to the top of the case, basically all you need to do is just pull up and it will free itself. Nice and easy. And now we're ready to take the optical drive off its mounting plate. So this is a relatively easy process too. So flipping over the optical drive, you can see there's just five screws that are holding that to its mounting plate. So we'll go ahead and remove those. And then with those removed, we've got the optical drive itself and the mounting plate separated. So we can get rid of the optical drive because all we need is the mounting plate. So next up, we can actually grab the GC loader. This is when we're going to start to install this. So let's do a test fit here and see where this is going to live. Make sure that the optical drive connector is in the right place. And it is. So what we'll do is just line those up, and Dan actually provides a couple of screws with the GC loader, and there's one with a washer, which I actually screwed up and forgot to put in. But when you're going through this, there are two regular screws that you'll just pop in place, and then one goes into a hole which has just a little bit of a bigger hole than the head, so you can see that is where the washer is needed. So super easy, just screw those in place, make sure everything's nice and tight, and we should be good to go. Next, we're going to be installing the GC Loader SD card mount. Now, this comes from Laser Bear Industries, and they did an absolutely spectacular job on this. It looks gorgeous, and the color matches the console perfectly. So looking at the bottom of the mount, you can see here, this is the extender cable for the SD card. So what we're going to do is plug the adapter into the SD card port on the GC Loader. Just plug that in, nice and easy. And then we'll line up the mount to the mounting plate. And then we're going to use just the regular screws that came out of the GameCube itself to mount this to the plate. One thing I'm going to mention, but I'm not going to show in the video because this did take an absolute age for me to figure out. I would recommend if you are using the SD card mount to pre-thread your holes. I actually tried to install the SD card mount without pre-threading the holes and it was an absolute nightmare. So I took it off and pre-threaded the holes just with the screws that came out of the GameCube. Just made it a little bit easier and a little less fiddly. So now we've got the SD card mount actually attached to the mounting plate. We can take a look and see what we've got. Again, this is a super clean install. The folks over at Laser Bear did a fantastic job on this mount, and the GC loader looks absolutely spectacular in place. Flipping the whole assembly over, we can see that the optical drive connector is in place exactly where it should be. And again, this is just a really clean, super clean install. So now we'll grab the rest of the GameCube and it's time to start reassembly. So the reinstallation is super straightforward. All we need to do is take the ODE assembly that we've got, flip it back over, and reattach the mounting plate to the console itself. When you're reattaching the mounting plate, just add a little bit of pressure to make sure that the optical drive connector is seated properly. It doesn't take much, and you'll know when everything's sitting flush. So now all we need to do is reinstall all of the screws. Just make sure that you take your time and get the right screws in the right holes. There's only two types of screw inside the GameCube, so it's not overly complicated. So with all the screws back in place, now all we need to do is reinstall the controller port. So a little bit of pressure on those clips and that will pop back into place. And again, with the AV output cover, same process, just pop it on and clip it in. While we've still got this all open, let's take a closer look real quick at the GC loader in place installed. Again, this is a super clean installation. I'm very happy with the final results here. Obviously, you can see the SD card mount on the top there and the GC loader in the bottom. Beautifully done. Very happy with this. So now all we need to do is replace the top of the GameCube shell. We'll just do a quick test on the disc tray open button. And that works great. And then when you open that up, you can see how the SD card mount works, replacing the original optical drive and giving you that SD card port right front and center. Very nicely done. And then all we'll need to do is replace the four screws on the bottom of the shell. But again, I'm not going to show you this because it's basically just screwing in screws. So now we've got the GC loader installed into the GameCube. Next thing we're going to want to do is set up our software. So we'll head over to the computer and we'll get that all set up. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is download a copy of Swiss. This is a homebrew utility which will allow you to use the GC loader to play ISOs. So the latest version of Swiss is available on GitHub. I'll include the link in the description below so you guys can get it. But all you need to do is scroll through here down to the download link and then click that. And that will download a zip file with everything that you need. Now, once you have these files, all you need to do is extract those to a location where you can find them. I use WinRAR for this, and I'm not going to show it in the video because I think everybody knows how to extract files by now. Now, once you've got your files extracted, you'll just need to go into the folder. So mine is called SwissR836. That's the version that I got when I was making this video. And then go into the ISO folder, and you'll notice there are three ISOs in there. Now, what you'll need to do is select the ISO which is for your region of GameCube. So mine's a Japanese GameCube, so I'm going to use the NTSC-J ISO. Now, what I will say is your SD card needs to be formatted to FAT32 file type. If you have a Mac, it's super straightforward, and you can do that through the disk utility. And if you have Windows, you'll just need some extra software for that. But I'll leave a link below in the description for some free software that will do that for you. So all you need to do is select the correct ISO for your region and drop it over into the root of your SD card. Next, head over to your SD card and rename your ISO to boot.iso. What that'll do is allow the GameCube to boot this directly as soon as you turn your system on. And from there, all you need to do is find your game ISOs and drop those onto the card as well. So super, super straightforward setup for this. Now, what I'm going to be using for this is one of the original multi-game demo discs from October 2001. So this should give us a good idea of how the GC loader works. Like I said, just copy that over to your SD card. And once that's done, you are good to go. So now the copying's finished, I'm going to take the SD card out. So let's hop over to the GameCube and we'll see what we've got. So that's actually super impressive. You'll notice there the GameCube intro animation didn't actually even complete before it kicked over to Swiss. I really wasn't expecting that, but that's really impressive to see. Now, what you're looking at here is the contents of the SD card, and obviously I only have the interactive multi-game demo disc and Swiss. So we're going to go in there and select the demo disc ISO, and it gives you a prompt here to boot. And there it goes. Now, this is the original demo disc from 2001, so obviously it's just got a couple of older titles here. But I think what we'll do is just take a look at Wave Race. We'll run the movie here, because I'm not very good at the game, to be fair. But this should give us an idea of how the audio streaming is, because I know there are some issues with other methods with audio streaming. You can see here that the audio and video streaming are excellent. There's no glitches, no buffering issues, anything like that. So very happy with this. Obviously, this is the first time we've booted this up, so I've really not had much chance to play with it, but everything seems to be working exactly the way it's intended. I do want to say a big thanks to Dan at Black Dog Technologies. I think he's done a fantastic job at getting this together and getting it to market. It's a revolutionary piece of hardware that I think is really going to revitalize the GameCube scene. And also, fantastic job to the folks over at Laser Bear. They did a great job on the SD card mount. I would definitely check them out if you are interested in one of those as well. So that's the installation and setup of the GC Loader ODE for the GameCube. I hope you've had as much fun watching the video as I've had making it. I've really enjoyed doing this project. It was super simple, straightforward, and easy to do, and I would highly recommend it for anybody that has a GameCube. If you did enjoy the video, please drop us a like and consider subscribing to the channel. It really helps us out. And don't forget to check us out on Twitter. Thanks for watching.